And now we're going to talk about the five major growth hormones that are found in plants, and we're going to describe their effects on growth and development, and this is Objective 28. First, we're going to talk about auxins. These are produced in the shoot apical meristem, and they promote apical dominance. They are found in young leaves, flowers, and fruit, and usually they will prevent the growth of axillary buds. And the apical dominance occurs when the terminal bud produces new growth instead of the axillary buds. So it's going to promote the growth of roots and fruit. And it's going to keep the leaves and the fruit from falling off. In fact, some farmers will spray auxin on their trees to keep the fruit from dropping off too early. And it promotes positive phototropism of the stems where they grow towards the sun. The auxins cause the stem to bend towards the sun. So when the stem has unidirectional light, the auxin moves to the shady side of the cells, and it binds to the plasma membrane receptors and activates a proton pump. And that proton pump that's activated pumps the hydrogen ions out of the cell. So the cell becomes more acidic. And that loosens the cell wall. So turgor pressure will increase because water enters. And so the stem elongates on the shady side. The cell enlarges when this happens, and the stem bends towards the light. Now, gibberellins promote growth. They cause stem elongation, and there are about 70 of these, and they all differ slightly chemically, but the most common is the gibberellic acid, and when that gibberellic acid is applied externally, the stems elongate, it breaks dormancy of the buds and seeds, and it hastens the development of the flower bud. And you can see here in figure A how you put the gibberellins there, how the stems get longer. It also in figure B will produce larger seedless grapes. So it increases the size of the flowers and the fruits. Now the cytokinins or cytokinins are hormones that promote cell division. And you find these in the dividing tissues of roots, in seeds, and in fruits. And they prolong the life of the flower cutting, as well as prolong the life of the vegetables when they're being stored. So the auxin and the cytokinins interact, and the cytokinins prevent senescence, which is just aging in plants. And that's what's responsible for the leaf color that changes in the autumn in our deciduous trees. Abscisic acid is made by the green tissue, the tissue that contains chloroplast. And we abbreviate this ABA. It's the stress hormone. So it initiates and maintains the seed and the bud dormancy, and it closes the stomata. With abscission, you're going to see the leaves drop off, the fruits drop, and the flowers drop. So this winter bud here is formed because of the abscisic acid. This is Indian corn, and that has reduced sensitivity to the abscisic acid.